Hey guys, it's Jill and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm doing a video that I haven't done in a pretty long time, and that is a good old-fashioned room decor video. All the DIYs are Tumblr inspired, but I definitely pulled some inspiration from Urban Outfitters and from West Elm as well, so it's like expensive decor on a budget. So if you're as excited for this video as I am, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and don't forget to click that subscribe button if you are brand new here, and let's go ahead and get into the DIYs. So to start this first DIY, you're going to need some scrapbook paper in whatever color or pattern you want, and then you're going to need a triangle stencil. I'll have the one I used linked down below just in case you want the same size as me, but you can use whatever size you want or you could just freehand it. But you're going to go ahead and trace that onto the back of your scrapbook paper, that way the lines don't show up on the side that you're going to want to use. And you're just going to go ahead and cut those three triangles out. Really simple and easy to do. You can do whatever size or shape you want, but I think triangles in the same general size will look best for this project. And once you have your three triangles, you're also going to need 9 photos of your choosing. I printed out 9 photos that I found on Tumblr, but you can use your own photos or whatever you want. Next, you're going to cut 3 pieces of string that are all the same size, and then you're going to attach them to a wooden dowel. I got mine from Michael's for super inexpensive and just painted it black. That way it'd match the color of the string that I chose. And I'm starting by just tying it into the middle of the dowel and then adding the 2 outside ones. That way you can space them correctly and it'll all be spaced evenly, which I am a total sucker for. So once you have those all tied on, what you're going to need to do next is start attaching your triangles. So I wanted my 2 outside triangles to be a little bit further up and for the middle one to hang a little bit further down. So I'm just taping the string on a little bit further down onto the outside ones and only taping the end of the string to the middle one. And somehow I didn't catch this on my video, but what you're going to do is just attach a string to the top of it. That way it will hang from the dowel. You'll see at the end sort of what I did. It's really easy. So next, it's time to attach your photos. So I'm just going to go ahead and lay 3 photos down right in the middle of the string. I definitely recommend doing your middle row first. That way, once again, everything will be evenly spaced. And once you have them lined up, you're just going to tape them in place and repeat this step for all of your rows. And that is it for this DIY. And here is the finished DIY. I think this came out so well. You can see at the top there, the string that I used, I just attached it to both sides of my dowel and then used it to hang it from a little nail in my wall. But I think this looks amazing. You can use whatever photos you want in whatever theme you want, and it's going to look so cool hanging in your bedroom. So I got itches that scratch. To start this next DIY, you're just going to need a shadow box picture frame. I got mine from Michael's, and then you're just going to take a Sharpie and write the word memories on the outside of your box. And then I'm taking the backing of my frame and just measuring out a piece of colorful construction paper to cover that up. You can do this in whatever color or pattern you want, or you don't have to do this at all, but I wanted mine to have a little bit of a pop of color. And as you can see, I'm just taping that into place. And then you're going to want to go ahead and add whatever memories you want inside of there. I put bracelets and wristbands and concert tickets and really whatever things I thought were special enough to go inside a memory box. And then you're going to add the back of your frame, and that is it for this next DIY. And here's what the box looks like when it is done. I think this looks so cool. It's a great way to display some of your favorite memories, and you can fill it up with absolutely whatever you want, whatever is most important to you. You can even change the word that's written on the box. You could have it say tickets, and you keep all of your movie tickets and concert tickets inside of there. It's really completely up to you what you put inside there and what you write on it, which is amazing. Last DIY, I got inspiration from a picture I saw on the West Elm Instagram. It was basically a set of canvases that all had different black and white patterns on it, and I got really inspired to recreate this myself for a lot less money. So I went out and bought some black paint and some canvases and just went off of that picture. I'm gonna have that picture linked down below, that way you can use it as a reference too. That way you can get some ideas for some other patterns. There were like 9 different ideas. So as you can see, for my first one, I just did some X's. For my next one, I did a set of 3 squiggles going down my canvas. And for my last one, I wanted to do sort of an ombre. And what's great about this is that the whole point of these canvases is that they look handmade and that they don't look perfect, which takes all the pressure off of you to create a perfect piece of art. In fact, I think it looks even cooler that it's sort of handmade and a little bit messy and not perfect. This ombre one was super easy to do. I thought it might be hard, but it actually turned out to be easy. You just wanna make the bottom of the canvas black, and then as the paintbrush runs out of paint, you're just gonna move it further up the canvas, and you're going to get a really cool ombre effect. And here are my three finished canvases. I hung them above my television and I think they look absolutely so cool. I think this would be a great DIY to do for above your bed, and you don't have to do yours in black and white if you don't want to. You can use whatever colors and whatever patterns you want and most fit your style. That's it for today's video. I hope that you guys enjoyed it. If you did, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. Also, don't forget to let me know down in the comment section what your favorite DIY was from this video and if you'd like to see more DIY room decor videos. And I will see you guys next time. Bye!